Hi, this is Aaron Murphy with ADM Architecture and the managing editor at empoweringthematuremind.com. Today I wanted to do a video blog about a blog that we wrote on months ago called CounterClockwise, Ellen Langer Has Me Thinking. So Miss Langer has me thinking about a study she actually did 40 years ago. I've been thinking about her study and where they put a group of older gentlemen into a setting where for a week they were living in a false framed society or a town from 1959. And what it did was actually documented proof of looking younger and feeling younger and having a better IQ at the end of the week. So that was pretty shocking to me. She did this in 1979, and when I read about it, it got me thinking a lot more about ramping up my efforts toward writing a book, which I think will probably be called Broken House, Broken Mind. Just a quote from someone who reviewed her book: if we could turn back the clock psychologically, could we also turn it back physically? For more than 30 years, award-winning social psychologist Ellen Langer has studied this provocative question and now has a conclusive answer. Opening our minds to what's possible instead of clinging to accepted notions about what is not can lead to better health at any age. In her latest book, she supplies the first detailed discussion of her landmark counterclockwise study in which elderly men lived for a week as though it was 1959 and seemed to grow younger. I think a lot about the built environment around us. As a licensed architect in Washington State, I've been a part of over 1 million square feet of public commercial buildings where there's inherently ADA and accessibility required in the design: ramps, elevators, stairs, bathrooms, all of that. But I also get to thinking about our spaces at home as it relates to the silver tsunami, what they're calling those 10,000 people a day now turning 65 starting in January 2011. So what I'd like to talk a little more about is just our mentality and our attitudes and how our internal thoughts, our self-talk, have so much to do with how we do or don't harness the power of our own mind. And I can't help but be inspired to dig a little deeper, and that's why I got CAPS certified. It's Certified Aging in Place Specialist. The National Association of Home Builders created that. It's an additional training on top of the years and hours of exams to become an architect. And so what I wanted to talk about with relation to that is just that statistic: 10,000 people a day turning 65 is going to drive our economy and my industry for the remainder of my career for housing and the residential part of my architecture firm. And so we started speaking publicly a couple of years ago on the aging in place phenomenon and the fact that you can stay home. 89% of those polled by AARP would like to stay home, even if their physical or mental abilities were to change over time. That it's your house, it's where you want to be. So that's why that stat is so high. I have baby boomer parents. I have a 92-year-old grandfather. I have a great respect for both of them, my grandpa and my father, my mother. Grandpa especially is one of my idols, in great health at 92. And so that's why we're out talking about this publicly. Will be in Chicago at the Aging in Place, at the American Society for Aging's National Conference called Aging in America in March of 2013. And again, I've started writing a book that'll likely be called Broken House, Broken Mind. So stay tuned on that. And for more information about us or more blogs, more resources and education, you can go to empoweringthematuremind.com. And you can find out more about what we do in the architecture field related to helping create forever homes so that you can age in place at ADM Architecture. That website is www.adm-architecture.com. Look forward to speaking with you again, and we'll be back continuing our blog series. Thanks. Have a great day.